What's going on, lads? Welcome back to the channel. This is an unexpected video. Normally we run the album reactions off of the Patreon votes, but this one's a bit of an exception. Some guys on Patreon have been like, Drew, you know what, sometimes just go about, you know, do your own thing, you know, forget about the Patreon poll. If something pops up, and just go do it. So I figured this would be a good opportunity to take you guys up on that offer, and I'm going to react to, I was going to say Eskimo Callboy, Electric Callboy's new album. I didn't know these guys did albums. I thought they just did crazy singles. So today we're going to be reacting to their new album, which came out yesterday. It is late in Ireland right now. It's the 17th as I'm recording this. It is 10:45 at night. And I just figured, you know what? I need some techno in my life. It's a Saturday. I'm not going out. So why not? I've reacted to a few of their songs over the past like year or so. I think I did like two. And really, really fun tracks. You know, I mean, exactly what they, you know, you know what you're getting when you get into these guys. So I'm expecting chaos. I'm expecting metal breakdowns. I'm expecting techno, being that the album is called techno. And I'm expecting, you know, the crazy vocals, the actually really impressive blending of the two genres, but also just being completely abrupt about it. So I don't know. So yeah, without any further ado, lads, we're gonna jump in. Make sure you drop a like in this one, and let me know if there's anything else weird, you know, random that I probably wouldn't be doing on the Patreon polls. Let me know if there's any albums that are a bit quirky that would be fun to react to, because it'd be nice to bring a new element into the channel of just like maybe once a week doing some like ridiculously out there genre, even if it's a different genre completely, maybe like rap or something. I don't know. If you guys want to suggest anything in the comments, like an album that is outside of the genres that I'm doing at the moment, then do let me know in the comments. Drop a like in this video. Make sure you're subbed. Patreon.com/DrewFortune. All the links will be in the description. And let's go. First track is called Pump It. Of course it is. Cascada vibes already. Cascada vibes. Shout out to anyone who knows who Cascada are. Let me know in the comments if you do. Oh, the lyrics are so funny, man. Just like proper poser music, you know? But in like a funny way, they meme it. It's kind of catchy, though. Fuck off. Oh, that's outrageous. Oh, they got me. Yeah. It just shouldn't work, but it does. Shout out to the person who thought I was drinking olive oil before. It's just water in an aloe vera bottle. Okay.
Pump it.
And if you feel like your body's giving up, you gotta kill the pain as you pump it harder. When if you feel like your pain is getting real, to fucking kill that bitch. To fucking kill that bitch.
What the fuck are these lyrics, man? Andrew Tate wrote these lyrics. I think I've heard this one. We got the moves. I'm 99% certain I've heard this one. We got the moves. I think I did a reaction to this one. It's just outrageous.
Beer, cheap wine, yeah, that's all that we need. We got the moves.
We got the moves.
And everybody's like,
let's go.
Let's go. We got the moves. We got the moves. When everybody's like, yesterday we drank too much. Let's do it again. We got the groove. We got the groove. So everybody put your hands right up. Tonight is a lie.
We are free. Sipping on boo. Oh man, it's so catchy.
The summertime memories.
By the Lord. I'm just DJing here as well, right? We got the move. We got the moves. They've like completely nailed the border between. Is this fan on really? Okay, that's perfect. Okay, right. Yeah, so they like ride that line of, I don't know whether to take them serious or, you know, just completely take them for a meme, because they are actually really good. But like, it's just because of the content of their lyrics and the, you know, not committing to any one genre, just bouncing between every single genre at once. You know, it's quite hard to know where they stand. To, you know, are they trying to be taken serious? But like, they've got a huge following. I've actually seen a live video of them play and look pretty good. So yeah, I would most certainly be interested in going to see them play if they did actually come to Ireland at some point. That would be a an interesting show to see, say the least. I'd say it would attract like the most random crowd of people, like, you know, people who are big metalheads, people who are, you know, into the dance scene. Like, God knows. Is this thing really that loud? One sec. I need to get wireless headphones so I can get up and start dancing and shit. Saturday night, man, living the dream. I forgot about this, man. Hard style, baby. I forgot about this, man. What's that thing that all the people in Australia do? What's that dance there? I forgot about this part. Yeah. Oh, these guys take the piss, man.
We are free. Sipping on booze on a Sunday.
Oh, I read the lyrics wrong.
We believe that summertime memories. We're young.
How could you not sing along? It's catchy. It's catchy. I'll give him that. Well, great track, to be fair. Great track. Metallica vibes. Dun, 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 dun. Fuckboy. All right, I haven't heard this one. Don't know who Conquered the Void are either, so interesting to hear like a feature on one of their tracks. These guys are German, right?
You don't know me like one day.
A peculiar bunch, the Germans.
Everybody thinks that I'm just a fuckboy.
These fucking lyrics, man.
Reputation.
I feel like I need the RGB cycle for the background light for this. Okay. Oh. this like your one Carly Rae Jepsen from That Friday Song? Remember her? Yeah. Does that sound like her? I mean, this would probably pass for a new Bring Me the Horizon track, to be honest. Fuck off, man. Oh, we got a laser. Here, anyone who has epilepsy, maybe click off. Oh, that's actually fucking me up, or anything. Shit when no one fucking asked. You know I love to watch your eyes roll back. You had a taste and now you're meaning cause you like that. You fuck around, boy, you should know I'm gonna bite. I don't care what they say, cause I need you to stay. Yeah, I want you so bad in all the worst ways. I don't care what they say, cause I need you to stay. Yeah, I want you so bad in all. Alright, this one's not bad. It's alright. It's alright. Let me go back to. Yeah, see, that one wasn't like out there enough for me to like be that into that track. You know, their other ones are just so ridiculously like in your face that it gives merit to what they do, but when it's just kind of like lingering in the middle of, you know, we're memeing but we're actually kind of making a serious song at the same time, it's kind of like, all right, well, you know, if I want these kind of songs, I'll just go to the charts. Not a bad track, but you know, I think this is a single as well, but I didn't hear this one. Another feature as well. Who's that? Finch. They are not using the same beat as Put a Donk on It. I refuse to believe that I'm listening to a similar beat to Put a Donk on It. Who knows that track? If you know that track, in the comment section, Put a Donk on It.
Yeah, yeah, it's sick, that. Yeah, that's good. Wait, hold on a minute. Play it up. Stop. You know what you want to do with that, right? You want to put a banging donk on it. Yeah, 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 that's sick, that is sick. I can definitely drop to that one. All we need now is like a hook line. You know what, I've got actually the perfect one. Bassline. Oh, wicked. Now put a donk on it.
Electro. Oh, that's sick, that mate.
Put a donk on it.
Techno.
That is bringing me back to when I was like, this was like some of the earliest music I would listen to. Wow. I didn't think I would ever hear something like this again in a song released in, or an album released in 2022, almost 2023. But look, history repeats itself, lads. We're going back to the early 2000s. Okay. Hachi, come on. I want some hard style. Bam, bam, bam. I never know which way it's going to go. Are they going to bring the bassline kicks in, or are they going to go with the guitars? Or this? Space man, got a rocket on my back. Space man,
Wo sind die Klingonen? Mach's wie mit meiner Ex, ich schieß euch alle auf den Mond. Hallo Leberwurst geschnallt, flieht die Kehle, kostet.
Oh no.
Von uns weg, danke Schwerelosigkeit. Unter. Yeah.
Unter. That is like, if you were to ask me, Drew, what's the last thing you would ever expect as a call out in a metal track to be said before a breakdown? Viva la Elton John. That is absolutely outrageous. Oh my god. Someone give me a translation. Not that it matters. The like broken English is hilarious. Is it a bird or just a man on his way to rave the universe? You have to love it. They're just having fun, aren't they? The universe is down for my rave attack. Mission complete. Well done, lads. Mind reader. Why did they change from Eskimo Callboy to Electric Callboy? Oh, wow. Yeah, this is DJ Zanny. Climax 2008 right here. Climax. Climax. Let me see if I can get a good voice for that. Climax. Oh, that was good. Climax. Okay, I actually like this one. This one feels a little bit more serious. As I climax again.
Climax.
Save my life. Yeah. You have to drop a patch, everybody knows it. Won't wanna cut my soul, none of your words. You have to drop a patch, everybody knows it. When I'm done with you, you'd rather be dead. Dead, so dead.
I don't know where this is gonna go ever, so I'm just being very careful about how I like move to it, because I'm gonna get caught out. It Yeah, that's pretty catchy. Pretty catchy. They really just are here for the vibes, aren't they? First time I've actually noticed the drummer, to be honest. Make me get up. I'm gonna get up. Oh, I can hear that swelling, that EDM swelling. Oh, I'm gonna get up a jump style right now. I'm gonna get up a jump style. Oh, yes. I need to get another camera so I can just not have to, like, move anything around so I can show you guys my jump style. Okay, we're going. Let's get a bit of acid or something in this. Like acidy bass techno kind of thing going on here. Oh yeah, we got that acid sound. Okay, that's new now. Like Okay, that was, like, all jokes aside, that was actually really cool. The acid sound is not something that I've heard them implement before. I had, like, my little acid stage, and I don't mean, like, taking acid. I mean the actual subgenre of, I think it's called acid, acid dance, acid trance, I suppose. Like, a subgenre within, like, EDM, techno. It's that, like, swelly, it's actually a really popular song. I wish I could think of the name of it right now. Oh, God, what is it called? I remember it used to be really, really good. If anyone knows, it sounds very similar to the intro to that. Oh, my God, what is that song? Yeah, that didn't help. Yeah, what is that? If I can think of it, I'll put it into the edit, okay? But it's probably not going to be likely. I haven't heard that song in literally, like, probably 15 years at this stage. But yeah, that was interesting, to say the least. The combination of that acid sound with the metal influence as well is that was actually, like, something I've not heard done before, full stop. I know, not just by these guys, but, like, literally anyone, so... That's pretty sick, to be fair. Oh, what is that song? You can still hear the acid in the background with the guitars. These guys have so much fun making these songs. Like, they're just like, let's just do this today and just make up shit as they go. That goes hard, like, regardless of the meme aspect of it. Okay. The chaos in these songs, is just so much going on. That was good though. That was probably my favorite on the album. Just, it was very, very unique. And we're back to techno. Techno train.
I take a ride on the techno train ride.
Fuck off these lyrics, man. It's so, like, oh. I feel like I'm being lurked out in a club. Right, done my techno train.
There is a whole new world that you're in.
one of Focus, man.
Destination love, but pleasure up above. You really can't stop the heat. I got lipstick on my feet. Licky, licky, sucky, sucky. Yeah, you make my lollipop me candy. Time, go get your dinner for one. You better go solve your face before we too late. Cause there's an eight night of a place on the car.
Okay, I kind of couldn't appreciate that breakdown there because, well, let's break down these lyrics, lads, okay? Where are we? Ride, take, ride on the techno train right now, okay? Good intro, good intro. Take your seat, setting the scene here, okay? So take your seat, I'm sitting down. Open up, feel a pounding bass.
Deep inside.
Shaky, shaky, sweaty, sweaty. Shaky, shaky, sweaty, sweaty. You make my spaghetti ready. Let me repeat that. You make my spaghetti ready. Okay. Where do we go from there? Heat up the sauce. It's dinner for one. Dinner for one. You better hold on tight. Because we're rolling again. Through the wetlands, down where the nature is playing. And when it's getting messy, I'm taking the blame. So he's taking some accountability as well, which is always good. Because I need you to stay on my techno train. There is a whole new world that you need to explore. It's the sound of a rail that you love and adore. We're riding on and on, because all you got is what? I missed the line, bollocks. Through the valley of love, because all you got is what? All you got is what? I want. Destination love. Ah, okay, so it's all coming together now. So the techno train is on its way to the destination, which is love. And there's pleasure up above, apparently, as well. You really can't stop the heat. Now, this is where I wanted to really get into the lyrics a little bit, because this is where, you know, things start to get, you know, he starts to get very introspective. You know, he starts to really, you know, tackle big problems that the world is facing, and you know, really thought-provoking lyrics here. So, you can't stop the heat. I got lipstick on my feet, licky licky, sucky sucky. Yeah, you make my lollipoppy candy time. Go get your dinner for one. You better go stuff your face before it's too late, because they're standing in line to grab a piece of the cake. And when the feast is over, we'll see us again next week, same time, on the techno train. Beautiful.
Shaky, shaky, sweaty, sweaty, you make heat up the sauce, it's a dinner for one.
I thought you said a dildo for one.
Licky, licky, sucky, sucky.
Oh God, if my parents heard me say this right now. Valley of Love, like we mentioned, that's the destination.
There is a whole new world that you need to explore. It's the sound of the rail that you love and adore.
Look at me! I already got the rhythm and the time.
Your attention, please.
Oh, here we go.
69 EC service techno train on platform AMPNV to Climax City is arriving at
Climax City, let's go! Climax.
I'm gonna
Okay, now he's taking the piss. Come on. Come on now. That is the most ridiculous lyrics I've ever heard in a song. I'm loving this new guy. I'm gonna take a wild guess at these lyrics being hilarious. Let's see if I can get a translation. Without rest and feeling. You keep pulling me to you. You are like a hurricane. It runs through my life. And you know perfectly well. I can never escape you again. Beat me up. Oh. Okay, we got English. Oh, we got a Dickie Allen feature. Okay. Yeah, I was reading some of the lyrics there. We didn't really miss out on much other than, what did he say? He said, she's hungry, she's horny, she's longing for flesh. So, I mean, look, your standard lyrics. No need to brush over that. So what music do you listen to? Well, it's complicated. Okay, catchy. Oh, they kind of faked me out a little bit. This is like is this the outro track? It feels like an outro track. It feels like it's the end of the night and everyone's on a mad love buzz. It is the last track, yeah. They've gone for that vibe. Oh yeah, this is good. Everyone's like hugging now, end of the night. Oh, how did I know that? I just knew. It just felt right that he'd hold that note there.
Ready to fly.
But yeah. I actually sound kind of decent with that on, that effect on.
Ready to fly.
That's, am I sounding good right now? It's all me.
We can't go back to the world it was to be with this. I am really begun.
I'm liking this a lot. This is really good. That's a fitting outro. I like the outro. It's nice and lighthearted, but it's actually really nice. Nice, catchy song. Really easy listening. That was actually a really enjoyable album. Something completely different to what we've been doing. I know I've done singles from these guys before, but it's weird to hear like a full body of work. But like, you know, it works. Like, you could hear, like, memes aside, you could actually listen to this album, like, not memeing, if that makes sense. Like, it's no wonder that their live shows look really good, because just seems like there's very good vibes all around. Like, I want to try and sing this part again. All right, so I'm gonna sing this part along with him. We're ready to fly, but I'm gonna put my voice. It's not even a voice change, man. It's just a bit of reverb and echo, but. All right, everyone, rate this. Be honest. I'm gonna cringe so much editing this back because it probably sound. Okay, we're not there yet. Let me try one more time, and then I'll leave you guys alone. And then I'll let you go, okay? But you have to hang around. Let me turn off the fan for this. I'm gonna fucking nail this. Nailed it, lads. All right, I'm not gonna annoy you anymore. Let's stop. Actually, it's between this track, Neon, and Parasite, which was the acid dance take that they had. But yeah, really, really enjoyable album. Like I said, something completely different. I don't know if I should give this like a traditional rating, because normally I would rate the albums at the end. Again, I always say take my ratings with a pinch of salt, because it's the first listen. This actually has like a good bit of replay value, to be honest. I was kind of thinking going into it, I was like, it's probably just one of these albums that I'll listen to once and that'll be that. But like, there's some bangers on this track. Like that Neon track at the end, like I said, they really nailed the vibe of that feeling of being at a concert or at a big rave or something like that. And you know, when they get the big strobe lights on, the really intense strobe lights for the last track, and it's just like this big euphoric moment. So they really nailed that mood. They nailed a lot of moods in this as well. They had like that Put a Donk on It track as well, which is really funny. A lot of like nostalgic feelings from this band. So they do that really, really well. So shout out to Electric Callboy, lads. If anyone knows why they changed from Eskimo Callboy to Electric Callboy, other than the fact that Eskimo Callboy is an absolutely ridiculous name, but it's kind of hilarious. And that's how I, you know, knew about them in the first place. But yeah, let me know why they went about that change, because it was like quite out of nowhere from what I had seen. And like, for a band to have already developed a name for themselves under Electric Callboy, to change to Electric Callboy is quite ballsy, because, you know, obviously search terms and that kind of thing, you know, if you're looking for Eskimo Callboy, look, I'm sure you'll find it, but like, you know, it's one of them risky things. So yeah, lads, if you did enjoy the video, please do drop a like. If you want to see more videos that are a little bit off the beaten track that we've been doing for the last few months, if not years, then do let me know in the comment section down below. It doesn't have to be, you know, these kind of meme sounding, you know, dancey pieces of work. It can be anything. So let me know in the comment section down below. We might start a new segment. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. All my links will be in the description. Patreon.com/TrueFortune, where we will be getting to the next album. This is probably going to be the next video I drop. So we have got some big videos coming up. We have Alpha Wolf, A Quiet Place to Die. I've gone completely blank. Architects, Holy Hell, I think is the name of that album. And then we have, what one of the other metalcore? Oh, we had the prog album was The Contortionist's Language. So they are the two albums that'll be coming up next. And yeah, guys, that is going to be me for the video. Like I said, drop a like. It'd be much appreciated. Make sure you're subbed to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'm signing out. Look after yourself. See you in the next one. Cheers. I never rate the album. I'd say, for what it is, it's an 8. It's an 8.5. It's a good album. We'll give it an 8.5. Right, lads, go on. See you later.